Welcome back. There was, of course, a spark of bipartisanship today at Capitol Hill, but most days the partisanship in Washington, it feels as if it just keeps getting worse. Party line votes, public divided by ideology and geography, a digital media landscape where it's easy to only hear your own opinions reaffirmed. It seems as if the political center has become lonelier than ever before. The armadillo in the middle of the road, or the dead armadillo in the middle of the road. If there ever was a true political center, former Democratic Congressman Jason Altmire of Pennsylvania might be close to it. He's boasted that while he was in office, at one point, the National Journal ranked him at the very center of all 435 members of Congress. But he lost a Democratic primary in 2012 after the area he represented was redistricted. He was in one of those member versus member races. And now he's written a book about our political tribalism called Dead Center, How Political Polarization Divided America and What We Can Do About It. And joining me in studio is the former member of Congress himself, Jason Altmire. Congressman, good to see you, sir.
Thank you, Chuck. Good to be here.
All right. Your book's called Dead Center. Deads in Red. Are you trying to describe what's unrepresented? Or the fact that, or are you saying the center is dead, as in period, the center's dead?
I hope it's not dead, but what has happened over the years and over the decades is we have less and less centrists in the Congress, and when you have less centrists, you're able to do less collaboration. And when there's less compromise, less work gets done, and therefore the country as a whole loses, because most people in America identify somewhere in the center. They have their politics. They might be a little right, a little left, but they want Congress to work together. They want to compromise and get things done. And they feel unrepresented in the current Congress because that's not what's happening.
What do you say to folks, though, that are more partisan that might say, because you're not the first one to make this argument, and this is certainly I'm inclined to buy your diagnosis of why we have this gaping hole in the center. But partisans on the left and right will say, you know what? We've won. The center has done a terrible job of making the case for their existence. So it's on them, not on the partisans. What do you say to that?
Well, I get asked all the time when I speak about this, why is there so much partisanship in Washington? The answer is because we elect partisans. The system is designed to elect and protect people on the political extremes. So what I talk about in my book is, how did that happen? Why does it happen? And what can we do about it? Because fundamentally, the country is not being represented when both parties have folks on the far ideological extreme.
All right, but which came first? Is it the voters delivering us candidates that are more polarizing, or the system forcing voters to choose between two polarizing options?
It's the system. The people who are more politically active clearly are more ideological. The research has shown that. But the closed primary system gives power and strength to that far extreme on both sides. So the folks who show up to vote in November in the general election wonder, why are my two candidates I have to choose from on the extremes? It's because, A, they probably didn't show up in the primary, and B, they might be excluded from the primary because they're an independent or other, and they don't get to vote in the primary.
Why would you say you made it to Congress? And the reason I say this is in Pennsylvania, a machine state,
right,
which is one of those states where it's right one lever, right, one party voting. You can just pull a lever, right, and you can just vote for all one party. How did you get through the system as a moderate then?
Well, I'm the perfect example, I think, of the problem, because I got in because I had a centrist message. It resonated with the general electorate. It worked for three terms. And then, as you said, I lost a primary.
But you got in a national way. You could make the argument that a partisan wave helped you. Even though you were a centrist, it was the partisan wave that got you in office, right?
Well, the partisan wave was driven by an 18 percentage point upswing in independent votes. It was not driven by the far left all of a sudden voting or the far right. It was driven by the independents. And what happened in the Congress for two terms, that worked very well. And then the far left turned on those centrists and pushed the agenda further to left than they were comfortable with.
You have a lot of interesting proposals to try to fix some of the polarization. My favorite is the 60% speakership proposal, meaning you have to get so. Explain it. What you want to see in the election of a Speaker of the House?
If you, as were running for the Speaker, and you had to win a 60% majority
period
in the House,
of the whole House,
rather than just 50% plus one, you would have to build your coalition from the middle out rather than from the extreme in. So the more polarizing figures that we have had as Speaker of the House on both sides would, in all likelihood, have been unable to win that because they would have had to get, in some cases, two dozen members of the opposing opposing party to support their candidacy for speaker.
So you don't think Nancy Pelosi could have won under those circumstances, and you don't think John Boehner could have won under those circumstances?
I don't think Newt Gingrich could have won under those circumstances. I don't know about Speaker Boehner. Perhaps he could have put that together.
And you don't think Nancy Pelosi could have?
I doubt that she would have been able to. But if those were the rules, of course, then you play the game differently and you moderate your message. But that's the whole point. When you have to appeal across a wider spectrum of ideology, mm-hmm. you moderate your message to appeal to them.
All right, but here's the real problem. The people to change those rules are the ones that benefit from the system that already exists. So what do you tell to the voter here? Read your book, says, I agree. Yeah. I want to see these changes made. The people in charge of making the changes are the ones that benefit from the old system.
Well, that's exactly right. But some of the changes are being made. The state of California has gone to open primaries where everyone, Republicans, Democrats, Greens, Libertarians, they're all in the same.
You want to see a California system for the country?
I think the country should go to open primaries, because if you're a candidate running in that system, you have to appeal to everybody, including people on the other side. In a current closed primary, you only have to appeal to the extremes. So it's no wonder in that system that you end up with people on the extremes representing you in Congress.
All right. There's a lot more I want to talk about with this, but unfortunately, I've gotten now two reminders that we're running long. Jason Altmire, former member of Congress, good to see you. Sorry about your Seminoles.
I knew you were going to bring that up. Thank you.
Yeah, actually, I'm not sorry. I'm not that sorry. We'd lost seven in a row. Anyway, good to see you. Good luck with the book. We'll be watching.